In this lesson, we're going to look at aqueous solutions. To start with, we're going to define a solution and describe its parts, and then we'll talk specifically about what an aqueous solution is. So just a reminder, when we talked about solutions earlier, we talked about the difference between homogeneous solution and a heterogeneous solution, or a mixture. So both of these are mixtures. A solution is always going to be homogeneous. It's going to be the same throughout. So salt and water will be homogeneous. Sand and water will be heterogeneous because we can see there's clearly differences in how those particles are distributed in that mixture. So the first thing we need to clarify is the difference between solute, and that's the substance that's present in the smaller amount. So in this case, it's the salt that's being dissolved in the water. And the solvent is the substance present in the larger amount. So in this case, we're looking at the water being the solvent. When we talk about solutions, we tend to think of them as being in the liquid phase. However, that is not the case. If we look at the air around us, for example, it is considered a solution. There's solute, such as the oxygen, that's dissolved in the solvent, which is the nitrogen. So we can have any combination of phases and still have a solution. So metal alloys that have a mixture of metals in there, one in a smaller amount and one in a larger amount, are considered a solution. A gas in a liquid, a solution. We can have a solid in a liquid. We can have a liquid in a solid, or we can have a liquid or a solid dissolved into a liquid. And so when we look at all these different, these are all called solutions. So usually what we are worrying about are aqueous solutions, which we'll talk about in just a second. But remember that solutions is a much broader term than we tend to use it in our everyday lives. Aqueous solutions are very specific type of solutions, and in those, the solvent is water. So anytime we see aqueous, we know that we're dealing with something that has a solvent of water. There are lots of different things that can be dissolved in that water, but ultimately our solvent is water. Now for the solutions that you'll typically see in a healthcare situation dealing with IVs, those will almost always be aqueous solutions.